Yo, what's going on, guys? Mush back at it with another video. In this video, I want to talk a little bit about PlayStation and them coming off of their quarter three conference call. It should be, you know, Sony's conference call, but nevertheless, there's some things that are very pertinent to PC in it, so I want to talk about that. And then also, Dying Light 2 is dropping on Friday. I do want to highlight the system requirements real quick for those of you guys that aren't aware. They've got four tiers of system requirements, two tiers for non-ray tracing, and then two tiers for ray tracing enabled, so we'll talk about that in a little bit. But first of all, they have first-party software growth plan. Sony does, I should say. PlayStation has their first-party software growth plan, and pretty interesting. Okay, so here is the exact excerpt. Credit to Benji Sales over on Twitter for posting this, but it was noted, in addition, we view the deployment of our game IP on multiple platforms as a major growth opportunity for Sony, as has been evidenced by the success of the PC versions of God of War and other first-party games. Through this acquisition, we intend to acquire new users and increase engagement on platforms other than PlayStation, and will enable us to significantly advance our long-term growth strategy of further expanding the ecosystem of our game business. Okay, so once again, I feel like we're getting news bits like this almost every week, bi-weekly, at least every month, of how well these PlayStation games are doing on PC. We've got three games to look at so far, Horizon, Days Gone, and God of War, and all three have been slam dunks to various extents. Days Gone's a little bit interesting because that was never viewed as like a top tier PlayStation release, but that game still did relatively well on PC. Actually, let me go pull up Days Gone right now on Steam. We're doing this live right now as I'm recording this video. Days Gone, let's give it a search. It is $30 right now on sale, by the way. Okay, so it has 20,472 Steam reviews, and this game dropped about 9 months ago on May 18th of 2021. 93% positive reception. Look, that's still a very, very impressive number. Now, obviously, if you look at games like Horizon and God of War, they're outpacing Days Gone by quite a bit. Horizon has 52,000 reviews, and then God of War. God of War just came out, and it's doing incredibly well. It's got 23,000 reviews already, but that just dropped back on January 14th. God of War does seem to be the most successful PlayStation release on PC thus far, and from that standpoint, it's kind of incredible because they dropped that game at $50 and it's still launched to the top seller on Steam. So it kind of goes to show that price point, yes, it matters to an extent, but if it's a game that people really want to play, they're just going to spend the money to play it. Like, God of War, $50, people still bought it on PC in droves, and I believe it had a very, very high concurrent player count. I don't remember the exact number off the top of my head, but it was definitely the highest among the three PlayStation releases, and ultimately, PlayStation and Sony are going to lower the prices of the game as time goes on. Like, Horizon's available now for $25, Days Gone available for $30, and Horizon you can find on, like, other e-tailers for, like, as low as $20 flat. I would like to see the games be a little bit cheaper, but I can understand from Sony's standpoint, you know, they know the business metrics, and they know how to make the most money, and they probably see that pricing it at $50 and then ultimately lowering the price is their best-case scenario in terms of making the most amount of money. But, I do think this means that, Uncharted's gonna come out on PC. It's gonna be very interesting to see how that game does, because Uncharted was a franchise that I feel like had a lot more buzz around it, maybe 7-8 years ago. I feel like that buzz has kind of dissipated, especially because Uncharted's just not around anymore. Uncharted 4 came out back in 2016. You know, we haven't had an Uncharted game since then, and I don't know if we're gonna get an Uncharted game anytime soon. We do have the Uncharted movie coming out, but nonetheless, very interested to see how that game does, because, you know, that game's gonna be a $50 release, probably. It includes Uncharted 4 and The Lost Legacy. Steep price point to pay, but, I mean, if past is prologue and we're seeing how these games are doing, if Days Gone did as well as it is, I would imagine Uncharted's gonna do better than Days Gone, so we'll see how that turns out, but it seems like from this standpoint, right now, these games are doing very well. Would love to see Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart on PC. I love that game on PlayStation. In my opinion, that's one of the system sellers for a PS5, even though the game's really, really short. Demon's Souls, of course, would do incredibly well on PC. Like, if you're talking about a game that would sell millions upon millions of copies, Demon's Souls is absolutely one that would do that. And, Ghost of Tsushima, obviously, would be another one. And I think Ghost of Tsushima's coming sooner rather than later. I think Ghost of Tsushima could be out before this year closes. And honestly, I could see it out sometime in the summer. All right, moving on from that, Dying Light 2 system requirements. This has been out for a while. Just want to reiterate these as we are getting close to the release of the game. Nice that we do have four tiers of system requirements. The reviews are also being posted. We'll talk about that in a second. But okay, so minimum, which looks at 1080p 30fps, this is no ray tracing. You're looking at the low preset Intel Core i3 9100 or an AMD Ryzen 3 2300X, 8 gigs of RAM, and the GTX 1050 Ti or RX 560. 4 gigabytes of VRAM on that. Recommended, you're looking at 1080p 60fps. That's on the high preset. Intel Core i5 8600K or a Ryzen 5 3600X, 16 gigs of RAM, and RTX 2060 or a Radeon RX Vega 56, and 6 to 8 gigabytes of VRAM is needed for that. With ray tracing, you're looking at, again, 1080p 30fps, low ray tracing settings, Core i5 8600K, 3600X, 16 gigabytes of RAM, and then an RTX 2070. That is so disgusting. A 2070 to play a game at a 1080p 30fps with low ray tracing. Recommended ray tracing, that's 1080p 60fps still. That's high preset with ray tracing, i5 8600K, Ryzen 5 3700X, 16 gigs of RAM, and then an RTX 3080 on that end. Look, I'm planning on playing the game at 1440p, and I want to get the game running at more than 60 frames per second, so it looks like ray tracing is going to be a no mas for me, so is what it is, but still excited for the game, and the game is getting relatively good reviews. Right now on Metacritic, it's sitting at a 76 for the PC version of the game. Looks like a main issue with the game right now is from a technical standpoint, and hopefully a lot of those issues are going to be remedied when the game officially drops, because there is a day one patch that is scheduled for the game. And hopefully that'll alleviate some of those issues. So, the game looks pretty solid. It looks like a game that's you're going to be able to spend a lot of time into. Obviously, Dying Light 1 was a game that I think a lot of people really did enjoy, and Dying Light 2 seems to be building upon that, more decision-making, and it'll be interesting to see how the game evolves over the course of 5 years, because the game does have a roadmap of additional content coming out over the course of the next 5 years. There's going to be free content, and then I believe, starting in June, the first paid DLC story expansion comes out, and then there will be another one after that, and ultimately, I imagine there's going to be more and more content. Look, Dying Light 1 had the same thing, where we had the following Enhanced Edition release, then we had the Platinum Edition released. So yeah, if you wait 3, 4, 5 years, you could probably get a better edition of the game, but I don't think a lot of people are trying to wait 3, 4, 5 years. So I'll be checking the game out. Hopefully it'll be a solid release. But that's going to do it for me again. Sony having, pretty good success with their PlayStation releases on PC. God of War doing well. Horizon doing pretty well. Days Gone not doing as well, but still seemingly doing pretty darn well. Hopefully we see a consistent stream of new PlayStation games coming to PC over the course of 2022 and beyond. And hopefully that window of the games arriving to PC does get shorter and shorter. And then Dying Light 2 system requirements, just wanted to get you guys up to speed with that. If you're trying to play the game with ray tracing, it's going to be pretty darn demanding. But that's going to do it for me. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comments section down below. If you guys have a request for a future video, you can leave that in the comments as well. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out. Hey, what's going on, guys? Mush here again. Hope you enjoyed the video. As you guys might know, YouTube's notification system is sometimes a little bit wonky, even if you're subscribed to the channel. Maybe you're not abundantly aware that I uploaded a video. To remedy that situation, make sure you hit the bell notification button. This way, whenever I upload a new video, and I try to upload as consistently as possible, you will be notified directly of the upload, and you can watch it as soon as it goes live. I would really appreciate if you guys hit that button, so you can stay up to date with all of the content I'm posting. But as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.